वेलकम टू लोकसत्ता, यशस्वी भव। यू आर अवेयर ऑफ द डिफरेंट लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। यू वुड हैव सीन अ बर्ड लेइंग एग्स इन द नेस्ट। यू वुड हैव आल्सो सीन हाउ अ सीड हेल्प्स इन द ग्रोथ ऑफ अ प्लांट। सिमिलरली अ कैट गिव्स बर्थ टू किटन्स। ऑल दीज प्रोसेसेस आर रिलेटेड टू रिप्रोडक्शन। रिप्रोडक्शन इज द एबिलिटी ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म to produce individuals of its own kind. Today we are going to study about the modes of reproduction. The modes of reproduction are asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. We shall discuss asexual reproduction in detail. In case of asexual reproduction, there is no union of male and female gamete. Only one parent is involved in the process of reproduction. Hence the chromosomal number remains unchanged. It can be represented diagrammatically as 2N, which is the parental cell, gives rise to the daughter cells. The daughter cells formed also have the same chromosomal number. We shall now discuss the asexual reproduction in unicellular microscopic organisms. Binary fission is a mode of reproduction seen in prokaryotes or in protozoans like amoeba. In case of binary fission, the cytoplasm divides and the nucleus also divides. This division is along an axis, either longitudinal or transverse. In case of multiple fission seen in amoeba, the amoeba withdraws its protozoa and secretes a hard covering which is called as the cyst. There is a division of nucleus under the cyst. This results into formation of multiple daughter amoebae. This process is called as multiple fission, which is seen in case of amoeba. Similarly, in case of yeast, budding is a method of asexual reproduction. In case of budding, a bud, that is an outgrowth, is formed in the yeast. The nucleus slowly and steadily divides and migrates into the bud. This grows gradually and forms the new body. This is called as budding in case of yeast. Now we shall study asexual reproduction in multicellular organisms. Fragmentation. Fragmentation is a process that is observed in Spirogyra. The filaments of Spirogyra, when receive water and minerals, multiply and grow. Fragmentation is nothing but when the filaments break into parts and each filament grows rapidly and multiplies rapidly. This is how a new filament is formed. Certain organisms have high capacity of regeneration. Regeneration is an ability of an organism to produce a new individual from its own cut body parts. This is very, very commonly seen in planaria and hydra. In this process, there are specialized cells which perform or work in favor of regeneration. These cells, they proliferate and grow in number in order to form the body parts and help in the formation of the entire body of an organism. Budding in case of hydra. In case of matured hydra, a small outgrowth called as the bud develops from the cell body of the hydra. This is the cell body, the digestive cavity and the body of hydra is continuous with this bud. This bud gradually grows in size. It receives nourishment from the parent hydra. When it grows, it detaches itself from the parent body and grows to form an adult hydra. This is how budding takes place in hydra. Vegetative propagation. In some plants, the parts of the plant body itself help in the propagation, that is in the process of reproduction. For example, roots. The root of sweet potato, when planted, grows to form a new plant. Similarly, the leaf margins that are formed at the edges of the bryophyllum produce to form a new plant. vegetative propagation is seen in certain plants. In this case, the parts of the plant body are responsible for carrying out the reproduction process. That is, if roots of sweet potato are planted, it gives rise to a new plant. Similarly, the buds that develop at the leaf margins of bryophyllum plant give rise to a new plant. Also, the buds that are present in case of potato give rise to a new plant. Thus, the parts of the plant body, that is the roots, the leaves, can give rise to a new plant. Spore formation. Spores are asexual reproductive bodies. The hyphae are thread-like structures that are found in the mucus. These hyphae at the tip bear a global structure which is called as the sporangium. Spores are present in the sporangium. On maturity and in favorable conditions, the wall of the sporangium breaks open and the spores are liberated. These spores then further give rise to a new plant. Thus, asexual reproduction takes place by the process of mitosis. In case of sexual reproduction, meiosis or the meiotic reduction is seen. In this meiotic reduction, the chromosomal number gets reduced to half. That is, 2n forms haploid gametes. 2n number of chromosomes get reduced to n and n. Thus, this is called as reduction. In case of sexual reproduction, fertilization is also the process which is very, very commonly seen. In case of fertilization, there is union of male and the female gamete which results into the formation of a diploid zygote. Thus, sexual reproduction takes place by the process of meiosis, which shows reduction, formation of haploid gametes, and fertilization, which results into the formation of a diploid zygote. Students, we have discussed the methods of asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. The advantages of asexual reproduction is that these processes are extremely rapid, but the disadvantage is that there is a lack of genetic variety. Whereas in the case of sexual reproduction, there is genetic variety and it prevents the extinction of species. Flower is the reproductive organ of the plant. A flower consists of four whorls: calyx, corolla, androecium and the gynoecium. The calyx, which is the outermost whorl, consists of sepals. These protect the inner delicate whorls of the flower. Corolla is made up of petals. These petals are colorful and attractive. They attract insects for pollination. Androecium is the male reproductive part of the flower. The androecium consists of anther and filament. The androecium is the male part that is called as stamen. Filament is a stalk-like structure which consists of a bilobed or a lobed globular structure which is called as the anther. The anther consists of pollen grains which are nothing but the male gamete. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part of the flower. It is called as carpel. Carpel consists of the stigma, style and the ovary. The stigma is the sticky receptive part. Style is the long tube which bears stigma at its tip. And ovary is the basal part of the style, which is a rounded globular structure. The ovary consists of ovules inside. The process of transfer of pollen grains from an anther to the stigma is called as pollination. The agents of pollination are wind, insects, birds, etc. The transfer of pollen grains from an anther of a flower to the stigma of the same flower of a same plant is called as self-pollination, whereas the process of transfer of pollen grains from an anther of a flower to the stigma of another flower of the another plant is called as cross-pollination. Thus, pollination takes place in case of plants. The pollen grains are carried by insects to the stigma. Stigma being sticky, the pollen grains stick to the surface of the stigma. These pollen grains then germinate to form the pollen tube. The pollen tube contains two male gametes. One of the male gamete fuses with the egg to form the diploid zygote, whereas the second fuses with the nucleus to form the endosperm. This takes place in the ovary, and the process is called as double fertilization. The endosperm provides nourishment to the developing embryo. After the process of fertilization, it is observed that the zygote that is formed divides several times. The ovule is developed into a seed and the ovary develops into a fruit. Thus, the seed that is formed starts growing to produce a new plant. Now, we shall discuss the parts of the human male reproductive system. The main parts of the human male reproductive system are testes and penis. The organs of the male reproductive system are located outside. The testes secrete a male reproductive hormone which is called as the testosterone. This testosterone is responsible for bringing about changes in males during puberty. Sperms are produced inside the testes. These sperms are then carried to a portion that is above the testes, which is called as the epididymis. A sperm is a male reproductive cell. From the epididymis, the sperm or the male cell is carried by a long tube that is called as the vas deferens. It is carried to the seminal vesicle by the vas deferens. Here, the seminal vesicles and the prostate gland secrete a fluid which helps in the movement of the sperm and which also provides nourishment to the sperm. From the seminal vesicle, the sperm travels to the penis. Penis is a muscular reproductive organ that carries the sperms to the site of fertilization. The sperm consists of head, the middle piece and the tail. The head carries the genetic information. The middle piece consists of mitochondria, which provides energy for the sperm to move. And the tail helps, that is the tail which looks like a flagella, helps in the locomotion of the sperm, which helps the sperm to move towards the female reproductive system. Friends, we have discussed about modes of reproduction and also studied about pollination and fertilization in plants and studied the structure of the male reproductive system in this video. In the next video, we will be studying about the female reproductive system.